What time is it? It's Puggsy time. We saw a little bit of this level in the last video, but we didn't have time to get through it. If you don't have the speed shoes, it makes this level a little more difficult. Not really difficult, just time consuming. What the game expects you to do is to build a series of platforms across here so you can jump up, and that's where the exit is, up on that ledge there. But I know of an easier way. Let's go ahead and leave that duck there. Come back for another one of these floating items for added buoyancy. Another duck ought to do it. And let's use our phenomenal swimming powers to launch ourselves up there. Scissors. What could those be for? There's nothing on this level you could cut. There's no rope or twine or anything like that. What in the world are these scissors? Interesting. You use the scissors to cut a mile-long hole in the solid ocean floor. Well, whatever. I really wish I didn't lose those balloons. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get back up there with this. Probably not. There we go. I usually don't even bother with that extra life, but I thought I'd show you how to get it just in case you wanted to. This level has a hidden exit that's really annoyingly hard to get to. I'm going to go ahead and do it though because it's worth it, and because, well, I vowed to find all of the secret levels. Let's go on a raccoon killing spree here. Okay, see that well over there? What we need is to put something inside that well. There's no coins around. I think that shell should do the job. Throw a shell in and make a wish. First, we need to figure out a way up there. The easiest way to do that, in my experience, is to get the speed shoes and build a little tower here. That should do it. I think the game expects you to use balloons to get up there, which I don't really see how that's feasible. I don't know. I've never actually done it that way. It's hard enough to do it this way. Alright, let's put that shell in there. And that gives us a coin. It's a kinky boot beast. Alright, this is going pretty smoothly so far. Let's see if I can get this coin in here without falling. Nope. I always fall at least once when I try to do this. Usually more than once. Take two. Oh, come on, no. Alright, let's do this. There we go. Put the coin in the well there. Gives us the coin back, and it opens up a nice little secret passage. That takes us to a cool little mini game called Pugs in Space. Some of you might recognize that name. And it's Space Invaders with ice cream, waffles, soda, and toast. Or bread. And that looks like one up. Wasn't that fun? I mean, we can go back there anytime we're running low on lives. There's always going to be an extra life there. A handy thing to have open. Okay, let's show you how to beat this level for real now. There's a mean raccoon down here holding a key, and this guy is unkillable. You can't jump on him. If you try, you're going to get hurt. Well, he's unkillable by conventional means. We're just going to have to be unconventional. There's a hint box back there, but I didn't bother opening it. I know what's in it. It's just going to be a key and a balloon. You may have saw a platform that the raccoon holding a key was walking over. The key to getting that key is in the platform. He's immune to bullets. But his worst enemy is a hole in the ground. He just can't handle it. Alright, the next level is also Splinter Town. I'm not sure I'll have time to get to this one. I'll try. There is a secret exit in this level too, which should come as no surprise to you. Actually, I don't know if we'll be able to get it without the speed shoes. We might be able to. We could, but it would require a lot more time than we have. So let's go ahead and save our game for now. And next time, we'll find the secret exit and the regular exit in Splinter Town, Part 2. See you later.